come home is an act of grace, and how can you facilitate the process of grace, you know, shining more on you?
By not trying to facilitate. You have facilitated so much all your life, have you not? What have you facilitated? What have you facilitated? The neighbor wanted to get his daughter married. You provided a helping hand. You have facilitated that. Somebody wanted to do something. You provided him counseling as per your wisdom. You facilitated that. Now, with the same kind of mind, will you also try to help God bring grace to you? Now look at the claim. God will bless me with grace. How can I help God? If possible, man will set up a helpline for God. Just don't obstruct, sir. Just don't obstruct. Grace is already coming your way. It has always been. Just don't obstruct. Don't try to facilitate. We do not know what it means to help. We do not know what it means to harm. When we have tried to help, we have only harmed. Don't try to help yourself.
No, my point was not about helping, about any sadhanas, you know, or any practices.
In going through sadhanas, don't you want to help yourself? You want to do good to yourself, or do you want to wish yourself ill? Whatever sadhana, practice you undertake, ultimately the intention is to do something good to yourself, is it not? Or do you wish yourself ill? No, you don't, right? So sadhana means doing good to yourself. Do we really know what is good for ourselves? Will our mind decide what is good for ourselves? Is that surrender? Will we decide what is good for ourselves? Not that I don't know the answer. Obviously, the answer is a resounding yes. Obviously, we will decide. Who else will decide? We are the ones on top. We decide our leaders. We decide our parliament. We decide what we will wear. We decide what we will eat. We decide whom we will marry. We will also decide what kind of sadhana. We will also decide the color of God, the wife of God, the birthday of God. When we have decided so much, then obviously we have a right to decide about the method of reaching God as well. We decide which river is holy, we decide which place God lives, we decide the height of the church, we decide whom to worship and whom to ignore.
Can we decide to surrender?
Yeah. So the next thing is, we will decide whether to surrender, how to surrender, to whom to surrender? Bring in the menu card, please. What is the list of options? We will decide. Now, is that surrender?
So we can't do anything.
Yes. And when you can't do anything, then much starts happening. When you don't do anything, then you get out of this lousiness, this inaction masquerading as action, then real action happens. But when you ask the ego says, if I don't do anything, then nothing will happen. Just like the cock. You know, what did he say? What did he say? The sun will not rise if I will not crow. If I won't do anything, then how will I even breathe? Along with you, everything that is required to sustain you is also there. You and the universe come together and are continuously together. You don't have to do anything. All the doing is anyway happening. Yes, the doing may happen through you. The grass grows on its own. Yes, And the grass grows even in Berlin, not only in Rishikesh. Or does it? Or does it not?
I don't know, I have no button.
Or do you have faithless grass? In Moscow, in Istanbul, in Berlin.